have written one time and another some sentences which have surprised me a little about death. Now, in particular, I remember you've said that death is psychologically just as important as birth, and like it, it's an integral part of life. But surely it can't be like birth if it's an end, can it?
Yes, if it's an end. And there we are not quite certain about this end. Because, you know, there are these peculiar faculties of the psyche that it isn't entirely confined to space and time. You can have dreams or visions of the future. You can see round corners and such things. Only ignorance denies these facts. It's quite evident that they do exist and have existed always. Now, these facts show that the psyche, in part at least, is not dependent upon these confinements. And then what? When the psyche is not under that obligation to live in time and space alone, and obviously it doesn't, then to that extent, the psyche is not submitted to those laws. And that means a practical continuation of life, of a sort of psychical existence beyond time and space.